Mike wants to compare this year's sales to last year's sales, but he can't figure out how to do it. We're going to show him the 6 simple steps to take to create a time intelligence calculation. Step 1 is to turn off the auto date and time setting. In a blank Power BI report, and I need to turn off the auto date and time setting. So I'm gonna go to the file menu, go to options and settings, go to options. In the global data load section at the bottom, there's a setting that says time intelligence, auto date time for new files. So all I need to do is uncheck this checkbox and press OK. And that will disable the auto date and time setting. Step 2 is to import the data. To import the data into Power BI. So I'm going to go to the Transform Data button, select Transform Data. This opens up Power Query. Go to New Source, Excel Workbook. Select the Data Workbook. Check the box, hit OK. Rename the query to sales. Step 3 is to import a date table. I need to import a date table. So I'm going to go to Google, type in extended date table. Select the first link. So here's our date table. I'm going to copy this. Let's go back to Power BI. Go to New Source, Blank Query, go to Advanced Editor, delete this, paste our code. So we have no syntax errors. Press Done. Now, right here it's asking for our start date and end date. Let's look back at our query. So we have dates starting from January 1st, 2020 to April 1st of 2022. So I'm going to say 1/1/2020, 4/1/2022. Press the invoke button. Now we have our date table. So our dates start from our start date to our end date and all the dates in between. And we have all the associated columns. I'm gonna rename this query. Call it dates. Then we're going to hit the close and apply button and send this to our data model. Step 4 is to join the date table with the transaction table. Now that we've imported our data and we've sent it to the data model, we now need to join the two tables together. So I'm gonna go to the model view. So we have our date table and our sales table. I'm gonna simply drag the date column to a date column in the sales table, which will be the order date. I'm going to ensure that we have a one-to-many relationship. So the many side will be on in the sales table. Change this to single. Okay. So we have one-to-many relationship. Step 5 is to mark as date table. The next thing I need to do is I need to validate that we have a correct date table. So I'm going to select the date table, right click it, choose mark as date table, select mark as date table. It's asking for the date column. We're going to choose the date column here in the date table. See right here, Power BI has validated successfully that we have a date table, and we just press OK. So that's how we can mark our date table. Next thing I need to do is create some time intelligence calculations. So I'm going to go to the report view, click on format, page background, change this to purple. I'm going to create a virtual table. So we'll go to enter data, call this DAX measures. This virtual table is going to contain our measures. Press load. You see it over here. So click it. Create our first measure, go to new measure, let's say total sales equals, do a sum, of the total revenue. Zoom in so you can see it. Total sales equals the sum of the total revenue in the sales table. So we have a measure. We can get rid of this column. We'll create another measure. A new measure. This measure here we're going to calculate the sales from the prior year. So we're doing a calculate function that looks at the total sales from the prior year. We'll create one more measure. Call it sales diff year over year. And this is going to be total sales minus sales last year. just like that. Oop, let me zoom in so you can see it. Right here. Now we're ready to create some visuals. Create a table. In the date table, we'll select month and year. Select the total sales measure. Sales last year. And sales different year to year. Then we're going to create a slicer for the year. Change it to a list. Select the year, 2022. So you can see the total sales for 2022, what the total sales were for last year, 2021, and the difference. Copy this table visual, paste it. I'm gonna create another visual from this. Just going to remove these fields here. Use a stack column chart. Create another visual. Let's copy this, put it here, so this is our cluster column chart for this visual. A bonus tip is to create a dynamic title. What I like to do now is show a dynamic title based on the 2 years that we're comparing against. So I'm gonna go to DAX measures, new measure. So we have a dynamic title called comparison title. So it's going to say comparison in sales between, and it's going to have the selected year that we choose in our slicer and the selected year minus one. So I'm going to change this title to that measure. So I'm going to select the visual. Go to the title, FX button, DAX measure, comparison title, hit OK. So it says comparison in sales between 2022 and 2021. Now let's create a title at the top. So I'm going to use the card visual. select that measure that we created. Turn off the category. Go to the data label. Change the text size to 25. So it says comparison in sales between 2022 and 2021. We change our slicer to 2021. Look at what our dynamic title now says. Comparison in sales between 2021 and 2020. Same thing here for our dynamic title. Now that Mike knows the steps to create time intelligence calculations, he is able to gain insights from his data and find trends.